Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Genetic Basis of Inheritance. In that, we are studying topic Polygenic Trait. When I say poly, it means many, and when I say genic, it means different traits. What is this polygenic traits? Let's study today. When I talk about the word or genetic term, polygenic trait. Poly means many, and when I say genic, it means different genes. Now, a character or a trait whose expression is brought about by a pair of genes, or you can say a set of genes, are nothing but polygenic trait. Or you can say polygenic traits bring about different quantitative as well as qualitative differences in inheritance. For example, when different genes, one set comes from a mother, other sets comes from your father, and these two set of genes mix together. Now, when they mix together, there are chances that there will be permutation combination happening and meiosis and crossing over happening. Now, this meiosis and crossing over will lead to certain traits, and which will be polygenic trait. Now, the expression of a certain particular trait in a polygenic trait is due to a cumulative effect of the gene. When I say cumulative effect, I can say the together effect or the addition effect of the gene. Now, there are lots of examples of polygenic trait. One example could be the human skin color. Another example could be the kernel color of the wheat or the wheat color of the ground wheat. When I say kernel color, it is nothing but the coating or the covering in which the wheat is present. Human skin color. Now, for human skin color, we all know that there are three different varieties available. One is the Indian variety of human skin color, another is the Britain variety of human skin color, and one type is the African variety of skin color. Now, in India, if you talk about the skin color of both the parents, need not be same. It could have differences. And whatever skin color your parent is having, if both are of a particular color, then you will tend to have the same color. But if both are of little different colors, there will be crossing over in genes, and this crossing over in genes will decide your particular skin color. The dark skin tone, the fairer skin tone will all crisscross to produce your skin color. During polygenic traits, even when the kernel of wheat or wheat covering was crossed, we obtained different ratios. The ratio obtained was 5:1 in F1 generation. Polygenic traits, that means different traits. Now, a character whose expression, or you can say a trait whose expression is brought about by a number of genes, or you can say a set of genes, is termed as polygenic trait, or you can say quantitative inheritance. When I say quantitative, it means certain things which we inherited in a particular sense. Now, we all know that any particular trait will be decided by two pair of genes that are present or located on the chromosomes. One parent pair of gene would be given by one set of parent, whereas the another pair of gene would be given by another set of parents. Now, the expression of these polygenic traits is always due to cumulative effect, or you can say addition effect of the genes. When all genes come together, permutation combinations happen, then the cumulative effect is actually seen. Examples of this is the human skin color and the kernel color in the wheat plant. The kernel color of wheat plant, or in wheat plant. Now, Herman Nielsen investigated the inheritance of kernel color in wheat plant. Now, basically, two pairs of genes control the pigment production in the kernel in wheat. And when he investigated and did his experiment, that is, he crossed the dark red color of kernel, that is capital A, capital B, that is dominant, with the recessive one, what he noticed was that all the dominant color was the most dominant one, or it was seen the maximum time. The F1 generation showed the genotypic ratio of 15:1, that is 15 red and 1 white, which clearly says that red was dominant. Students, I hope you all are clear with this concept of polygenic trait. Thank you.